hold it together, and you're looking at the rings. And what you can do is, remember this is boiling hot, you can squeeze a few drops into a teaspoon. Now it'll be boiling, going into the teaspoon, it'll cool it a little, and then that can be put into the ear.
Barbara, how long do you steam it for?
Till it's soft. Now if you've got someone who's in a terrible state with earache, you might really push it on a high heat and maybe you'll have a little one like this. This is a very good size for a child. You might have it soft in 15, 20 minutes. Dry bake probably take a little longer, yes?
Can you squeeze it in the teaspoon? Would it not still be too warm for the ear?
Oh yes, but how? What's the temperature of the teaspoon? Cold. And it's only a few drops. And so we'll go from boiling to lukewarm on a cold teaspoon. And when someone's got an earache, you don't want to put cold things in there. And so just warm is very nice. And then you'll wrap it up. I found a wonderful little tea towel in the drawer out there that had a hole in it. Now that's the ones you rip up for your conferences. And it's a nice fine cotton. So what you might do is you might use a tea towel, you might use a hand towel, and you wrap it over a few times. See, we've got it wrapped over a few times, and then you test it on your forearm. If it's still a little bit hot, you might wrap it a couple more times, and then you apply it to the ear, and then you can put a piece of plastic. Now, with this cling wrap, very hard to handle. So can you see I've folded it over a few times? And then you would put it like that on the ear. What did they use before plastic? They used wool. And I sew, and I love making wool skirts to keep myself warm in the winter. Unfortunately, I didn't bring any wool skirts because I thought I was coming to summer.
Yes.
And I cut up little squares from the bits and pieces from my sewing, and I have them in a little pile. It's a good idea to, over the next few days, buy a box and make your own poultice box. And then any old tea towels looking a bit thin, cut them up into squares, and you might cut some wool into squares. But I do find that even with wool squares, you put the wool square over that and then the plastic over that, because nothing stops the moisture and the air like plastic. But in my hormone lecture, I will be